Hey, horse people. Hello, monkey. So I just gave the horses a little ear corn. Of course, Buddy ate his first. And now he's going to go take Mr. T's. Because Mr. T was slow, he couldn't see his. And if they have a sale on corn at the store or something, I'll, you know, pick up a couple ears and just give them each an ear of corn. Maybe once a week, maybe once every 2 weeks, a couple a month. It's not that big of a deal. I'll throw the whole thing out there, shucks, corn and all. And like I said, Buddy already ate his. That was Mr. T's. I give him one ear of each. But Buddy's being a pig. Mr. T. Poor old Mr. T. He's like, that was my ear of corn, Buddy. I don't want to give him two or three ears each or give him a lot or give him a basket. But one ear of corn. Good boy, Mr. T. Tell him to back up. It's just kind of a little variance on nutrients. It's not cooked. Like I said, I buy it fresh. And then I throw the leaves and the shuck, just the whole thing. I don't do anything to it. I buy it full ear of corn. And I just throw them one ear of corn each. And I don't give my guys a whole bunch of different foods. Like I said, I'll give them a pear, an apple, an orange every once in a while after I peel it. Buddy will eat part of a banana. Mr. T doesn't like bananas. They're not real big fans of strawberries or tomatoes. And again, when I say I give them this, it's very limited. It's not like I'm feeding them a basket or a bunch. Same way with my grain. I only give them a little bit of grain. Mr. T usually goes get some salt after he eats almost every time. He's gonna make a liar out of me. Buddy, what are you doing, boy? Why'd you take Mr. T's corn? You're in big trouble. You want a beating? Yeah, I didn't think so. You're gonna be in big trouble. Mr. T was eating his corn and you ate yours too fast and you stole Mr. T's and there ain't no sense in that. There ain't no sense in that. You're gonna be in big trouble. I'm not putting up with it anymore. Good boy, Mr. T. I know, he's a good boy. I know. Mr. T's a good boy, I know. You're gonna get a spanking though. There ain't no sense in that. I'm tired of you stealing Mr. T's food because you're young and you can't. That old man taught you a lot. You better respect him, boy. So, anyway, I meant to grab my camera before I came up with corn. I threw it out by the time I went back in. Of course, Buddy had already smashed his up. Feeding horses, everybody, what do you feed them? Look, you got to be careful. Less is more. And if you feed them anything very small, that's a damn carpenter bee up there right above Buddy's head. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. I don't know if he's coming out of camera. I keep trying to fill up those holes and paint and do all kind of crap. And those guys keep coming back. But anyway, feeding horses, I get distracted. Bees. Buddy being bad. Let's see if I can get that little bee going in that little hole. There he goes, little shit. I saw you going there. I know. You're a good boy. Oh, look at those teethies. Oh, look at those teethies. All right. Well, just gave a lot of people are always asking me, what do you feed them? What can't you feed them? Look, don't feed your horses grass clippings. It's not good for them. Don't feed them, change their diet a lot and shock them. Don't feed them a whole bunch of anything at one time. Very small amounts over different periods is the best way to kind of just not shock the system and not cause problems. Remember, horses can't throw up, they can't breathe through their mouth. So if they get something bad in them, it has to go through like 75 feet of intestine and 25 feet of small intestine. So it's got a long path and it can do a lot of damage. And that's when it hurts and they get a bellyache. When they get a bellyache, they start rolling and thrashing. And when they do that, they end up twisting a gut and you end up colic and it kills a horse. Hey, Rick, you can't kill a horse by giving him something bad. Well, yeah, you can. And horses die every day from it. But, you know, they just go, oh, it's colic. Well, it's colic because usually somebody fed them wrong. either right before working out, went out, ran the crap out of them, or right after they work out, when they're sweating, they just throw them some food and they gobble it down. They don't feed them enough. They don't break up the hay. They give them old hay. But since that's the only thing a horse, if a horse only has bad hay to eat, he's going to eat it. And then he'll colic and he'll be like, oh, I love my horse. I just fed him and he colic. Yeah, well, that's because you're an idiot. All right, buddy, you're a good boy. A lot of idiots in the horse world, ain't there, buddy? Ain't there? There are a lot of idiots out there. I know, there is. All right, we'll end that there.